Right, time to talk about motion in space. This goes with section 3.4 from the Calculus 3 textbook by OpenStax. And we're going to put together all the stuff we've done with vector-valued functions to describe the motion of a particle, where its position is defined by a vector-valued function. And in particular, we get up to the point of describing the acceleration function in terms of its tangential and normal components. So we've been talking about r as a vector function of t, the parameter, and we've done it as a space curve and a plane curve. And in any other situation, this vector valued function could represent the position of some object as a function of time. So t is time, and then this is its position in two or three dimensions. If that's the case, then the derivative with respect to t, r prime of t, would be the velocity of that object. And its second derivative, r double prime of t or v prime of t, would be the acceleration. I know you probably know speed as the absolute value of the velocity, but if velocity is a vector, then we think of speed as the magnitude of that vector. And so we would take the magnitude of v or magnitude of r prime. So in two or three dimensions, in terms of the component functions, these are the formulas for position, velocity, acceleration, and speed. The book likes to use a non-bold v for speed, but you may see other people use other things. I sometimes like to use s. And I know we've been using f, g, and h for these component functions. Well, they're back here to using x, y, and z for the component functions in this context. But t is time. Now, if we again imagine ourselves in some kind of vehicle, like in a car moving along the road, at any given point, our velocity vector is tangent to the path we're on, right? And we saw this when we first talked about the tangent definition of the tangent vector and found out that it was the derivative of the vector function, which is the position. Well, the direction points in the direction of the path at that moment, and then the magnitude now could be interpreted as the speed at that point in time, because magnitude is the magnitude of the velocity is the speed. In the same scenario, if we now incorporate acceleration, well, there's two aspects to it, right? If we're heading in a straight line, then acceleration is just the rate of change of the speed, right? It's how much you're speeding up or slowing down. But in general, your velocity is not just the speed, right? It's also the direction. And so we now have to incorporate contributions from speed, which would be the tangential component of the acceleration. And then also the changing of the direction of the velocity, right? So when you turn the wheel, you could be at the same speed, but you turn the wheel and make a turn, and that changes your velocity. Even though the speedometer is at the same number, right? And so you'll feel that normal acceleration kind of pulling you to the side in the car. So the tangential acceleration is due to changes in the speed or magnitude of the velocity, and the normal acceleration component is due to changes in the direction of the velocity, you turn it. Now, this is just a review of the principal unit tangent vector. Which one of these formulas is how we calculate the unit tangent vector. So you should have identified B as the correct answer, right? Principal unit tangent vector is r prime over the magnitude of r prime. So B is the correct answer here. How about the unit normal vector? Well, you recall that the unit normal vector is A. It's t prime over magnitude of t prime. And you might be tempted to say c because you know that t is related to the derivative of r, and so t prime should be related to the derivative of r double prime. But because of the way the normalization occurs in two separate steps, this is not quite right. All right, now let's go through the acceleration vector derivation. Acceleration as a vector function is the derivative of the velocity vector. But we already talked about the velocity vector being broken up into the speed, right, which is the magnitude of that vector, and then its direction, which is the unit vector version, right? And the unit vector of the velocity vector is the tangent vector, the unit tangent vector. So we're kind of holding off on the derivative and just saying, okay, velocity is made up of speed and direction, right? Now we can apply one of the properties of the derivatives we saw, basically the product rule for a scalar times a vector. And like those, all those product rules were the same. It was derivative of the first times the second plus the first times derivative of the second. So go ahead and apply that product rule here. And then you want to recognize that this derivative of big T, the derivative of the tangent vector function, is related to the normal vector function, right? It just needs to be normalized. And so what you want to do here is actually multiply on both sides by t prime of t. Okay. And then those will be gone. And so the derivative of the tangent vector function is going to be equal to that. And so then it goes right here. That's how you get from the first line to the second line. We didn't mess with that part. It's the exact same. Then we recognize that the curvature formula, one of the curvature formulas, relates the magnitude of t prime and magnitude of r prime. And we do the same kind of thing where we multiply by magnitude of r prime on both sides. These cancel. So we take magnitude of t prime and we replace it with curvature times magnitude of r prime. And you see the curvature there. And this is the speed, right? And then the speed, one of those is just that one. And the other one is magnitude of r prime. Because r prime is the velocity and the magnitude of the velocity is the speed. So that is v, the speed. And then, of course, multiplying those two together, we get v squared. So this writes the acceleration in terms of the two directions, the tangential direction and the normal direction. And it says in the tangential direction, the acceleration is just due to change in the speed, which we already thought. And that in the normal direction, it's just due to turning, right? Not strictly the curvature of the curve that you're turning on, but a combination of the curvature, how fast is, but how fast you're going. So you've got to do the square of your speed times the curvature to really see the effect of the turn on the acceleration. Now, when we go over to theorem 3.8 and we write out the tangential normal components, you see the notation is that you use a subscript of a big T or a big N for tangential or normal components. And so these will be the magnitudes of the tangential and normal acceleration, the directions we've already talked about, the tangential and normal vectors. And then to get those here, we just use, take the dot product of the acceleration vector with the tangential or normal vector. Now for the top one, we are going to use this formula here, right? And so A dotted with T is A dotted with R prime over magnitude of R prime. Now magnitude of R prime, that's just magnitude of V, right? So that's that part. And then R prime is just V, so this is A dotted with V over magnitude of V. So they just took out the T dependence function notation. It's still implied. And then went from R prime to V to give you this formula. So that is how you might actually calculate it from the acceleration? Because usually you start with the r, you're given r, and then you find the derivative to get v, and then you find the second derivative to get a, but a is not broken down the way you want. It's broken down in terms of I, j, k, and you want it instead in terms of tangential and normal components. So this is how you get that one. Now, the easier part of this bottom formula is just to see that, well, the magnitude of a squared should be the should just be a t squared plus a n squared, right? Because the acceleration vector is broken down into its tangential components and its normal components. So to find the normal component, you can just solve this equation for a sub n. To get this other one, you really need to go back to that curvature formula. So starting with this, that the normal component is the curvature times the square of the speed. And the square of the speed is just magnitude of v, the vector v squared. And then one of the curvature formulas was v cross a over magnitude of v cubed. This was like the second curvature formula. And now it was written in terms of r. And so you probably see it as r prime cross r double prime, and then r prime cubed. So just in terms of the function r, it was written with r prime and r double prime, but r prime is v and r double prime is a. So that's the curvature formula. And then the magnitude of v cubed and the magnitude of v squared cancel out and just give you one magnitude of v on the bottom. And then of course the top is the same magnitude of v cross a. So it's not hard to see where those formulas come from if you look back at curvature and what we just did on the previous slide. And that's it. So that finishes up chapter 3. Again, this presentation by Matthew Watts contains images and text from Calculus Volume 3 by Jed Herman and G. Strange. Thank you so much, OpenStax, CC BY, and CSA.